How you doing? I'm Ryan Wright.
And I'm Jerry.
Welcome to Reasons to See.
We're gonna give you some reasons to see.
Maybe not to fucking see.
Don Jon.
Let's go jerk off. Reason to see number one, Don Jon. Joseph Gordon-Levitt's acting, fantastic in this film. Quite enjoyed it a lot. You know what's great about this is everyone knows that he like did everything on this film, including writing and directing it. It was awesome to see a movie where it's like, yeah, going in, I knew he wrote and directed it, but I was so engrossed in the character and the performance, and I completely just stopped being aware that he was even behind the camera at all. He's really funny. He's extremely confident. Joseph Gordon-Levitt just has that swag that can totally pull off that level of confidence.
Yeah, I've never seen him play quite such a Guido guy, like your, you know, Jersey Shore dude, and you know, you kind of do lose him into that character.
Yeah, he's all about living up to a certain image he's created for himself, and you know, it's the total like macho image that a lot of guys just try to live up to, you know, workout body, getting bitches on the side all the time, you know, and of course porn. He's really good with the porn addiction stuff in this movie. You know, like, believe it or not, I have studied a lot on porn addiction and sex addiction. There's a weird fascination I've always had with it, and I thought he did a great job with the portrayal of it, because this guy is a porn addict who's in denial that he's a porn addict. It's so authentic in a certain way, but it's done in such a comical way at the same time. Joseph Gordon-Levitt just knew this guy in and out. In and out.
Maybe Joseph Gordon-Levitt is a porn addict.
Maybe that's what he was basing this off of.
Maybe he just loves porn.
Yeah, his own real life experiences.
Reason to see number two, Scarlett Johansson.
I quite enjoyed her in this movie a lot. You know, I thought it was gonna be distracting when I saw the trailer. I thought I was like, oh, she's gonna put on some phony accent and whatever. But then I saw the movie and I totally bought her as this character.
You buy her as a Jersey girl.
Yeah, she's very believable. You forget you're watching Scarlett Johansson. High maintenance, you know, kind of controlling, well, very controlling type of person. It's funny because it's like, Joseph Gordon-Levitt's a porn addict, and he's falling in love with someone who's like a love addict, a romantic addict in a way, you know?
Well, yeah, they're very much similar characters, especially for the first part of this movie, you know? It's like, they have their different obsessions and their different images that they're trying to embody, but in the end, they are the same type of person.
Yeah, it's another character that is, because this film's getting criticism for its, you know, the stereotypes, but I think that's the intention of this film, is to have stereotypes really played up to get these points across, because we all try to sort of live up, like the majority of us try to live up to these certain images of what a man should be like and what a woman should be like, and here's what women want and here's what men want, and the clashes of that really feel authentic in this film. Yeah. But in a funny and entertaining way the whole time too.
Those are real things that people obsess over in real life and try to live up to because they think that's real, and it sort of prevents you from having those authentic feelings, you know, when you're dealing with people. So I kind of agree. I think the stereotypes serve a purpose in this movie. You've seen these types of people before, and it's sort of an exploration of who those people are and what they become.
And I think the main messages get communicated through Don Jon and Scarlett Johansson's character. I'm very impressed with actors who have to play like really confident people. To me, I'd be so self-conscious in doing something like that. Because, you know, for Joseph Gordon-Levitt to pull this off, you have to be like super fucking confident when you do it. And for Scarlett Johansson's character, you gotta be super fucking confident to pull off a lot of these lines, a lot of these scenes in general. And damn, do they do a good job, and the chemistry between them, they really play off each other very well.
Yeah, they do, definitely.
Reason to see number three. Tony Danza.
Yeah, Tony.
Tony, he's back!
He is back. Where'd he go?
The role we wanted him to be in.
Did he go somewhere?
I don't know. I remember he had a talk show for a while and that went nowhere. Yeah, Tony Danza. I wasn't expecting to walk out of this movie talking about Tony Danza, but I really enjoyed him in this film. He plays Joseph Gordon-Levitt's father, and the dynamics between father and son, it totally makes sense why Don Jon ended up becoming Don Jon based off his, not just his dad, but his parents. He's so funny in the role too, and he's believable. You know, what I love about the acting in this is you got strong stereotypes, but they're done with such a level of sincerity, and Tony Danza totally brings that. It's like, you know what, Tony Danza, this guy can totally fucking act.
I don't really know how to elaborate on it. I just thought he was really good.
Yeah, you know, he's a small character. He's definitely a supporting character. Damn, is he like a delight to watch every time he's on screen?
Oh, totally. Yeah.
I just haven't laughed so much at a film in such a long time.
I laughed so much at Tony Danza.
In Tony Danza, you've never made me laugh this much. Yeah.
Reason scene number four. JGL's writing.
I was really impressed with the script of this film, you know, because you're dealing with a lot of tough subjects, and it's easy. This film, I guess, is a dramedy, if you were to categorize it. Yeah. And there's a lot more comedy than your typical dramedy in it. That's what I really appreciate about it, was that it's a dramedy that lives up to the omedy part, you know? A lot of dramedies are so dramatic, with a lot of just black humor. I don't mean like, yo, what up, dog? I mean like, dark humor.
It's true that there is a lot of humor in there, you know, from the types of characters these people are. Like I said before, it's kind of like you're taking these Jersey Shore type of guys and then making them human.
What I just really appreciate about is that there's all these different elements that you have to play with here, you know, from like porn addiction to the machoism to all these other different things going on about. It basically is anything that Don John is going through, that is what's being communicated through feelings on the screen. In a weird way, it's like its own world because it's kind of weird at times and kind of funky.
Well, yeah, you know, you're in his world.
Yeah, exactly.
The world that this guy occupies. And part of what's so cool about his writing too is that, you know, it's like every character has a sort of very distinctive quality about it, you know. Even though they're all New Jersey folks, you know, they all have a distinctiveness about them. And also, this movie uses a lot of, like, internal narrative. I think he did a good job with that, too, because that's usually something people scoff at. But in this movie, it's, you know, the internal narrative is very much based in the in Don John's mind. And so the internal narrative isn't just sort of dictating what's happening on screen. It's also a window into how he views things. So it's not always reliable to the truth, but it's reliable to his character and the sort of changes that are going on.
Reason is scene number five, JGL's directing. The direction of this is very neat because like what I was saying with the writing, it's totally captured in the way with the directing of how the feelings of what Don John is feeling, that's what you're gonna feel based off the way how, not just how it's written, but just how it's captured as well. He knows how to work with his editor pretty damn well, you know?
Like, oh yeah, it's definitely got a visual style
to
it. And it does have a rhythm, because a lot of the movie revolves around this guy's routine. And so as they, you know, keep establishing and keep using the routine, there's lots of creative editing and really cool shots and stuff like that. And it all sort of goes to serve what this guy's life is, you know?
Yeah, and I liked how he deals with all the themes of everything, you know? Like with porn addiction, for example. Even if you're not a porn addict, everyone has their own different opinions on it, but I really like the dynamic of how it was such a big problem for Scarlett Johansson that her boyfriend is looking at porn and when he's in a relationship. Because I know that there are some people who won't give a shit and some people look down upon it. In porn addiction, you know, it's a real thing and a lot of people disregard it as it not being a real thing. But do some research, you'll find out it's a real fucking thing out there. And with porn addiction, you usually get people get criticized a lot of time on their character. Like, oh, they're selfish, they have no self-control, you know, there's womanizers and stuff. And the way how he captured it, he managed to make it such an entertaining fashion. He managed to capture a serious addiction with such an enthusiasm and confidence at the same time.
Yeah, definitely, and it's not in a way that's overly cool, but it's also not overly condemning either. It's just a fact of this guy's life.
Yeah, he's not trying to hit any points in your head. You know what I mean? He's not trying to bash anything in your brain.
Well, it does bash the idea that this guy watches a lot of porn.
I mean, other than that, but I'm saying it's not trying to bash like a message in your head.
Yeah, it's not taking a big preachy stance and going, this is wrong, or let's watch porn, you know, like.
Yeah, like a lot of people are saying like, it tries to be deeper than what it really is. But I think when people say that, I'm like, no, I just don't think it's as deep as you want it to be. I think it's just deep enough.
John is not an incredibly deep guy to begin with, and the whole movie is sort of about watching this shallow kind of, you know, New Jersey robot guy turn into a real person, you know?
Yeah, he's a guy who's like totally detached from reality, detached from his emotions in so many ways. You know, it's like that's why people like him get hooked on porn, because it gives them a certain feeling that makes them feel, you know, feel in general.
The shots are very composed and it definitely has a succinct visual style. The editing is interesting. Even the cinematography, from even like lighting standpoints, there are cool things they do with lights and stuff like that. You know, it's as a directorial effort, you know, I'm good first one out of the gate.
And he knows how to cast very fucking well. Yeah. Like he got all the right actors together. That everyone has, there's a great rhythm with the dialogue in this movie.
Reason to see number six, Julianne Moore.
Can't really go into it without ruining the film. She's an important character in this film.
Yeah.
Someone who starts off being introduced as a small character, but eventually becomes, you know, their character's more elaborated. She does a really good job in the film. Like, that's almost about as much as I can say.
She's really good. She's very real, and you know, there are some definitely impressive moments, you know, that she has to really act in.
And again, the chemistry between her and Joseph Gordon-Levitt is really solid as ever. You know, like, with two very different age ranges, they play off each other incredibly well. You know, like, and it's important. I pointed that I can't go into why, but it's important.
No, she's definitely very well cast, and she does a fantastic job.
Redheads, I like redheads.
Redheads are rad.
Pornhub.com, look up redheads.
There's a lot of, I wonder if Pornhub gave them money.
I think so, because on the Pornhub website, I was on it before we did this review, and they have advertisements for this movie.
For Don Jon?
Yeah, I had to find out before every porn clip, yeah. Split decisions, the last 30 minutes. Okay, I like the last 30 minutes, but that is where my few flaws come in. I thought it's, even though it's only a 90-minute film, I thought it sort of dragged a little bit in the end, because I kind of wasn't sure where the direction of this was really going. I thought it got a little too serious, you know, because it's very comical for a lot of it. There's always a certain level of comedy, and then it got, like, very serious for the last 30 minutes. There was still some humor that got interjected, but much later on in the last 30 minutes.
Yeah, I didn't necessarily take it that way, because, I mean, I didn't feel like it vastly changed gears. I thought the drama took over a little more, but the first hour of this movie is funny. Like, there's lots of humor that comes out of these characters, but it's not like, hey, comedy, and then, ooh, drama. Like, I thought the shift made sense with the characters and with the story, and the tone wasn't jarring at all. You know, I really liked the last 30 minutes, and that's when the biggest character shifts happen, and that's what I was most compelled by, so I didn't even hardly notice.
I just thought the first hour was just a ton of fun, and I felt that level of fun, like, significantly dip for me. Like, I was still intrigued, I was still interested, just the fun level was not there, really. And I guess it's not supposed to be there in those moments. I don't know, I just didn't like the feeling of feeling my energy just drop. Then again, I watched this movie this morning based off 0 hours of sleep, so that might have to do with it. But, you know. And I won't go into it, but the ending, I kind of didn't like. It's weird. I liked the ending, but I didn't feel like the story was finished at where it ended. I thought there was gonna be more after the last scene that we saw, and then it just sort of ended for me. And then I was like, oh, I guess it's over. And I didn't quite get why it ended at that point.
See, I didn't feel like it sort of ended. I feel like it ended at the right point in this character's life, because to continue any further beyond that, it would either have to be a very long film or a really rushed wrap up, because we end at a point where he is become a different person. To continue on past that, then we would have to see his life as that guy.
Yeah, I felt like this was like a chapter one in Don Jon's life. Like, it's weird, because this is not the type of film that would get a sequel, but I would, if they made a sequel to it, like Don Jon Chapter 2 or something, I would totally check it out. Ryan's consensus. Despite minor things, Don Jon is the reason movies are made. Despite minor things, Don Jon is the reason movies are made. Yeah, you know, here was my day. I had literally no sleep. I was up all night catching up on Breaking Bad, and I was falling asleep during the trailers. And then this movie just really uplifted me. It picked me up. It woke me up. Here I am doing a review, and you know what? I love a movie that can just do that in a unique fashion.
Jerry's consensus. A good debut and a very enjoyable movie is the reason to see Don Jon. A good debut and a very enjoyable movie are the reasons to see Don Jon. You know, I think it's a really solid debut on all fronts for Joseph Gordon-Levitt behind the camera, and I really enjoyed it. You know, I thought it was a well-drawn movie, and I might actually go check it out again when I'm more sentient.
All right, guys, thanks for checking out our review for Don Jon. Why don't you go ahead, scroll that comment box below, and tell us, what is your favorite Joseph Gordon-Levitt performance?
Yeah, and once you're done doing that, come over here and click this button so you can see more episodes of Reasons to See, because there's a bunch of them.
And there's a few things I like. One of the things I like is if you like us on Facebook. Yeah. Another thing I like is if you follow us on Twitter.
You know what else I like is people who want to get updated every time new reviews or videos out. And for those people, I recommend that you
subscribe. Subscribe. Do it. That's what we like, and you're going to do it.
Yeah.
You know, Joseph Gordon-Levitt, I love people. You know, like, you got a very unique haircut. And Joseph Gordon-Levitt has unique hair in this movie, too. Yeah. And I like people who can pull off unique haircuts.
like last week with Jake Gyllenhaal.
With Jake Gyllenhaal in Prisoners. Yeah. There you go again. Or Johnny Depp and everything that guy does. So yeah, no, I love his hair a lot. I you know, at one point Julianne Moore is commenting on his hair, and I was thinking, you know what, I would touch his hair too. I like that hair.
And I also agreed with the comment. I was like, yeah.
Yeah, it does look better like that if you do. Yeah. Yeah, Julianne Moore, I don't know, she's like 59 or something, but she is still gorgeous.
I don't think she's that old.
Yeah, well, yeah, I don't know. 40s, 50s, what's the difference? She's a woman, she's old now.
But you just basically called her 60.
Yeah, yeah, well, you know, once you're past 40 and you're a female
actress. Once you're past 40, you're 60.
Yeah, that's how it works when you're a woman.
You celebrate your 40th birthday, and then a year later you're celebrating your 60th birthday.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Surprised you're not thrown on the streets yet.